Dear friends, how is your Lent going? This 40-day period, although actually it's more like 46 days, but we don't count the Sundays, they're feast days, so you don't fast. This 40-day period is when we are supposed to concentrate a little more on God, on our path of discipleship, on getting ready for the great celebration of Easter. So how is it going for you? Have you managed to avoid the bacon sandwich? I'll explain exactly what I mean by that in a moment. Our Gospel tells the story of Jesus' temptations in the wilderness. Jesus has just been baptized, and the Father has endorsed his ministry, telling him that he loves him, that he is proud of him. This fundamental affirmation changes Jesus. He is filled with the Holy Spirit, and the first thing that happens is that Jesus is now driven into the wilderness, where he has to struggle with the Satan. Jesus must be so aware of the power now available to him, on which his ministry will depend, and along comes the Satan to say, "Do it for me." The Satan offers worldly glory, all the kingdoms of the world. Note that the Satan isn't lying when he offers this. Jesus does accept, in John's Gospel, that the Satan is the prince of this world. But Jesus recognizes that nothing must come between himself and the Father. Worship the Lord your God and serve only him. That is the rock on which the temptations break, that Jesus resolutely puts the love of the Father before everything else. We are called to do the same. Jesus later teaches that anyone who loves his father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. Anyone who loves his son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Bracing stuff. But this is the path of life. We have to put God first. And that's difficult. It's difficult because we are tempted. Which brings me to the bacon sandwich. The image I'm drawing on here is from C.S. Lewis's The Screwtape Letters. For those of you who aren't familiar with it, The Screwtape Letters are advice from a senior demon to a junior demon about how to prevent people coming to the truth. On one occasion, the senior demon, Screwtape, is describing a situation where a man is very close to making a major spiritual breakthrough. And the younger demon, Wormwood, is wondering how to prevent that breakthrough from happening. Screwtape says this, and I'm paraphrasing, "Don't try and make a frontal assault, trying to overpower his mind with suggestions of different ways to think. That will only encourage the man in his quest. It'll feed his sense that he is wrestling with important matters, the very stuff of life and death. No, what you need to do is plant within his mind the idea of a bacon sandwich. This will distract him from what he is doing. He'll think, 'I can come back to this later.' And then, after he has had the bacon sandwich, the urgency of the moment will have passed, and he will wonder what he was getting so worked up about. His soul will then be safe in your keeping." So I ask again, have you managed to avoid your bacon sandwich? The purpose of Lent is not to go on a diet, as if for these 40 days we can have divine sanction for our vanities. No, the purpose of Lent is to increase our concentration upon God and the things of God. It is to try to encourage us to put our bacon sandwiches to one side, not because we are giving up meat for Lent, but because we want to come closer to God. The resolutions that we make in Lent are props for our willpower. They're like the handrail on the side of the stairs. If we stumble, then we have something to cling on to help us keep going. Imagine that the man that Screwtape is discussing had made a resolution that he would spend 1 hour a day listening to God. That simple measure would help him from being distracted, and it would give time for God to work miracles in his soul. The heart of Lent is the intention to come closer to God, and our resolutions need to remember that, to remember that however lovely a bacon sandwich might be, it can never be as wonderful as walking humbly with our God. May God's grace go before us and enable us to enjoy his presence this Lent and always. Amen.